Hi students, before I start with part 3 of this session, I would like to make a correction here. It is question E, fourth part. I told you that this is a correct sentence, so there is no change. It was my mistake, children. Please listen to the rule now. The cattle is grazing in the field. Here cattle is my noun and field is my noun. Now this cattle, as per rule 3 in the note box, which reads, some nouns appear to be singular but they actually denote plural number, for example cattle, people, police, etc. It means that cattle is a plural noun, and when my subject or a noun is plural, the verb which it will take should be plural. Please make a note here, cattle is a plural noun, or you can say cattle is a plural subject. And when our subject is plural, the verb that it should take should be plural. So answer will be, the cattle are grazing in the field. Now let's move on to question A and B. Now students, to start with question A, you require to have knowledge of subject, singular as well as plural, plus the verb which should be used with these two subjects. You may make a note here. If your subject is singular, the verb which you will use is be1 with s or es. And if your subject is plural, your verb will be only in its basic form, that is v1. So let's get started. While explaining, I'll be telling you whether the subject is singular or plural. So we start here. Physics-my favorite subject. Here physics is the subject of this sentence and this is singular. So being singular, it will take a singular verb. Physics is. My hair-black. Now hair stands for the hair on your head, and it takes the rule of uncountable noun. Hair being uncountable noun, if you remember, on the adjacent page, in the beginning, very beginning, I have made you put a star there, that uncountable nouns always take a singular verb. So it will be, my hair is. Otherwise also, the hair on your head always take a singular verb, and if these hair are on your other body parts or on your legs or arm, it will be hair are. Moving on to the next question. This pair of shoes dash me. Now you may find that we are talking about shoes, but actually we are talking about pair, and this pair word is singular. So it will take a verb with S or ES. Answer will be pinches. Next, my shoes. Now here if you see, we are talking about shoes, and shoes is a plural subject. With plural subject, we take only V1, that is no S or ES. So it will be, my shoes pinch me. Next, what dash the latest news? Now here the noun is news, and news is a noun which is both singular and plural form, which has both singular and plural form same. So it will be, what is the latest news? Next comes the audience dash clapping at the Joker's antics. Now children, here the subject is audience. This audience is a collective noun. Actually, when a collective noun works as a unit, or they work together, or they do the same action, it should be taken as singular. And being singular, it will take a singular subject. So answer will be, the audience was. Next, his pants dash dirty. Here pants refer to one pant, But if you imagine a pant, you'll find it has two legs. So it's always taken as plural. This is rule one. This is rule one on this page. Let's read it. Some nouns are used in the plural form only. Scissors, glasses, spectacles, shorts, tongs, clothes, shoes, add a word here, pants. So when this word is in its plural form, so the verb which will be used will be again plural. So answer will be were. Dash the police knew who the culprit was. Culprit was. Here again this police refer to rule 3 in the note box. Police refers to a plural number. So the verb will be without S or ES. So I'll be ticking do here. Do the police know who the culprit was? If this word was policeman, it would have been singular and my answer would have been does. Coming to question B, underline the correct nouns given in italics. Again, you have to consider the noun or the subject of the sentence. Basically, the subject of the sentence. The dog sank its dash into his finger. Probably he would have put his finger, the person's finger, into his mouth. So it will be teeth. You may underline or circle as you wish. Otherwise, the indication is underline. I have just had a dash out. Now, a shows that it cannot be teeth, because a stands for one. So answer should be tooth. This is a dash note. This is a 10 rupee note, not 10 rupees. My dad gave me two, again the answer will be 2 10 rupee notes. The words which will be plural is note and notes. Next one. Tell me what happened in your own words. Take a sentence in Hindi. Apne shabdon mein batao ki kya hua tha. He is a man of his word. It is a expression used for the person who does what he or she says. That means he or she keeps his promise. In other words, he keeps his words. Next, what is your name and address? The boys exchanged. Now, it is blue boys. So, everybody must have exchanged their addresses. Floor is sold by the kilogram. And please give me two. This two shows kilograms of rice. Next, children. We'll turn two pages further and we'll do the A part. It is to be done in the book itself. Let's turn the page. Children, before we start this question, I would like you to take a minute and write whatever I have mentioned on the page above. Point one, two, this, only this much. One, 2 points. Take a minute and write. In case you have not written by this time, you may pause the video, write it, and then resume the video. So, shall we start? The question reads, underline the nouns in each of the following sentences, then write them by changing the number of the nouns. Make other necessary changes too. Now, we'll take this question stepwise, and only a few will be done by me. The rest will be your homework. Step 1. We will only underline the nouns in the following sentences. Let's start. The child was playing with a doll. Child and doll. The woman was carrying a large black bag. Woman, bag. Hari went to his friend's Hari, friends. Do you love eating chocolate? Chocolate. There isn't much furniture in the room. Furniture, room. Next questions, I'll not read. I'll simply mark. Rohan, Ritesh, maid servant, police, culprit, advice. Advice is an abstract noun. Daughter, prayer service. I missed a word here. Job, cattle, fields, cockroach, hole, thief, painting, pet, studio, beggar, shelter home, neighbor, sandwich, car, sun, fox, animal, child, book, tree, air, book, photo, Jimmy, key, story, mother, child. Now, we'll be taking up the second part of the question, that is step 2. Write here step 2 for the second part of the question. Then write them by changing the number of the nouns. While changing the number, you have to keep in mind a singular subject will change into a singular noun will change into plural noun, and a plural noun will be changed into a singular noun. Let's start. The child was playing with a doll. Now, child will become children and doll will be dolls. Now, if my subject is children, which is plural, my verb should also be plural. So, this will be changed to verb. The woman was carrying a large black bag. First, change the noun. Woman will be women. Bag will be bags. And if my word here or my subject here is women, this verb should be plural, that is were. Hari went to see his friends. Now, Hari is a proper noun, so it will not take any change. The change will be here with the word friends. Do you love eating chocolate? Chocolate will be changed into chocolates. There isn't much furniture. Furniture will remain furniture only. It stands for plural. The things that are in your house like bed, sofa, all are counted as furniture. In the rooms. Rohan was fighting with Ritesh. Here there is no change because proper nouns do not take a plural form. The maid servant is absent. Maid servant should be changed into maid servants. Next, the police caught the culprit. Police is already plural. Let us leave it like this only. The police caught the, what can be changed? Culprit can be culprits. Could you give me some advice? Could you give me some advices? Actually, children, if you will Google this word or Google for the plural form of advice, you will find both the words as plural form. Advice may take a plural advice itself, or there may be an S added to the word. Both are correct. So this sentence can read, could you give me some advices? Or it can be, could you give me some advice? Both are correct. She congratulated her daughter on getting a new job. She congratulated her daughters on getting, will drop a new jobs. You may write the complete word jobs or add an S in the bracket. The prayer service was performed on the banks of the Ganges. Now, Ganges is, we call it Ganges, not Ganga. Ganges, so we will not change it because it is a proper noun. Prayer service can be changed into prayer services. and was will be changed into were. The cattle were grazing in the field. Now, cattle being a plural noun will take were. So, this is correct. And fields, as I told you, if your noun is singular, you will change into plural. And if it is plural, you will change it into singular. So, fields will be changed into field. Okay, children, the rest part is your homework. Carefully do the homework and mind it. I've already marked the nouns. You have to change the noun from singular to plural and plural to singular. Then see whether the verb used is correct or not. For example, in question number 20, my son wants to buy a luxury car. My son will be changed to sons. Car can be changed into cars. Now read the sentence again. My sons wants. Now this verb is wrong. With the plural subject, my verb should be without S or ES. It will change into want. So while solving the exercise, please take care of these changes in the verb pattern also. Now let's take question number C. Identify and underline nouns in the following passages and classify their kind. We'll take up this in parts. We'll take up this question again in parts. First, we will identify and underline the nouns, and then we will classify them in their respective kind. Let's get started. The novel opens on an island where two boys meet. One of them is Ralph, who is standing near a lagoon. The other boy is Piggy, who is fat and wears glasses, but talks intelligently. Their conversation reveals that these boys are English school children. So we'll underline English school. This word is together. Children, whose passenger plane was shot down over the ocean and crashed on an uninhabited tropical island. This word is together. Ralph and Piggy are curious about the fate of the other boys who might have survived the crash. Just then, they spot something in the water. It is a large pink and cream colored shell. Piggy suggests using it as a trumpet to assemble others on that island. So I've done with the first part of the question, identify and underline nouns. Now let's classify these nouns which we have underlined into their respective kind. Children, I missed two words. Conversation, underline this also, and here crash. And this word English school children, you'll mark it together. English school children. It refers to children who are studying in an English medium school. Now let's do the second part of the question. Classify their kind. For this, you require to stick a page here or just check whether your adjacent page has some space. We know there are five kinds of nouns. We have to categorize them accordingly. So you may write here proper noun. Common noun, collective noun, proper, common, collective, abstract, and material. You may also stick a page and make a note of these five kinds of nouns there and then categorize. Now we'll take one by one. Novel. It refers to any novel. Now the words novel, island, boys, these are common nouns. So put them in this category. Novel. Novel. island boys. Let's go with the other words. Ralph. And see the word piggy. They start with the capital letter and these are the special names. So it will come in the category of proper nouns. Likewise, children, read all the words marked in a particular line and categorize them, whether they are special names or a common or a group name or a feeling or something like that, and write it in the respective category. Here, I would just like to add there, I think you will find problem in that, the words which we underlined conversation, crash, they will come in the category of abstract noun. You can have a conversation, but you cannot touch. Or we can say words which we can feel, which we can imagine, they come in the category of abstract nouns. Crash. These are abstract nouns. So children, you will do the rest part of the work which is left. Thank you. And please read the content pages at least once after the session gets over. Thank you, children.